Let's turn it over
to
John Vina.
Ladies and gentlemen, be sure to check out our Instagram page at Combat Zone MMA and our Facebook page, Combat Zone LLC, for exciting pictures, news of upcoming shows, and free giveaways. And the Radisson Hotel would like to thank the Combat Zone staff, especially Calvin Cater, for putting on another successful event. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your Combat Zone 61 Resurrection main event of the evening. Scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds for the Combat Zone Amateur Featherweight Championship. This championship bout is proudly sponsored by NH Distributors, MacMalkin Cadillac, CW Hemp, and American Irrigation. And your referee in charge of the action once again, Kevin MacDonald. And now introducing first, the challenger, fighting out of the blue corner to my right and wearing gray shorts, entering the cage with a record of 4 victories with only 2 defeats. He's representing Triforce MMA. Please welcome John Douma. And his opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner, the defending champion, wearing black and entering the cage with an incredible record of 5 victories with only 1 defeat. He's representing professional martial arts. Please welcome the defending Combat Zone amateur featherweight champion, Brendon the Kid Marotte.
All right, here we go. Everyone's leaving the cage, locking the doors, getting ready for battle. Referee Kevin MacDonald gets the fighters ready, and here we go.
Okay, Brendon takes center. John comfortable with the outside. Brendon's a taller, lankier fighter. He's going to look to find his range, take advantage of that.
Both of them going with a couple of swings. No one really connects. Sizing each other up. Trying to find the best opening to get these things underway. And wow.
Big overhand right from John misses.
Marotte comes right back. Ooh, throws a kick, spins right around. No contact. Very quick movements from both of these guys.
Lots of feints out of John Douma. I like to see the feints. The feints will help set up a nice punch. And there you see it. He lands a overhand right. Grazes Marotte's chin. Marotte with a big head kick whiffs.
Almost fell down while doing it. That's not what you want. Oh, kind of a blocked kick there.
Marotte with a kick. And Douma goes for the takedown, but Marotte concedes and pulls guard. Now Douma in the top of guard, works belly, body head. Marotte looks to work a triangle. Douma just content sitting a guard.
Both fighters trying to gain a good position right now, but both very squirmy.
Marotte with strikes off his back, and he's able to stand up.
Wow, nice.
The crowd responds, obviously.
Wow, that was a nice escape by Marotte.
Douma with a nice shot to the head, and Marotte now capitalizes his own shot.
Oh, getting a bunch of good shots to the chin.
As Douma goes for a single leg there, Marotte was just cleaning him up on the chin.
Got about 20 seconds left to go in the first round.
Now that position I talked about earlier where Douma has his head underneath his chin.
Yeah, I saw him doing that over there.
It's uncomfortable. We got 10 seconds left now. Douma quickly went to mount, and Marotte reverses the position and gets back up, firing shots. Nice head kick lands.
Wow, good head kicks, good moves.
Right at the end of the round.
And Douma is coming back here bloody in two spots on his face. Excellent. One on the nose, one on the side of the face.
Excellent first round. Really hard to score. Douma with a couple takedowns, but Marotte was able to reverse. I think Marotte got the better of the strikes in that round, landed more damage, and had controlled the cage a little bit more. So
absolutely.
You could score it for Marotte, but I can see him scoring it for Douma for the control of the takedown over there. So this is going to be one of those rounds that it's going to come to the end of the fight where we're wondering, what did they score in that first round?
Right, absolutely. But you called it perfectly. Douma wanted to keep it to the ground. And Marotte was having nothing to do with that. Got himself out every single time, got it back on top. All right, the crowd is clearing. The cage is being locked up. Round two, ready to go.
So let's. Loudest I've heard the crowd all night, singing along with the song, cheering on.
Yeah, they're definitely looking forward to this fight. So far, these guys haven't let him down.
Marotte's got a lot of energy this round. He comes out, takes center. Lots of feints, lots of jabs.
He ended the first round really good, so I think he's coming back with some confidence.
Douma with the overhand rights.
Marotte wants to land that kick so bad.
Douma's landing the overhand right, but it's slow. It doesn't look like it's very heavy when it comes in. Marotte's got quick piercing jabs.
He does, definitely. Oh, Marotte wanted that one, but Douma gets a hold of him, brings him right to the ground.
I like that he's committing to the punches, but that, it was just too much. Douma was able to shoot, come underneath, take him down. Now he finds himself in guard inside Douma's corner. He's working a butterfly guard, looking to get a sweep. From here off his back, he can get a scissor sweep where he'll use his right foot to push the guy up over and scissor sweep him to his left side.
Marotte's holding him down there pretty good.
He may just look to stall here, hold him. Look for the referee to stand him up, but he's able to stand up on his own.
Marotte's
stalking. Wow. Stalking, finds himself almost getting taken down again. Uses an inside trip. Douma with the takedown again, right into side control.
Douma's playing it smart, man. I wouldn't want to stand up against Marotte either.
Yeah, he's got his agenda. His agenda is just to take him down, control from the top. We know that's coming. We know that Marotte wants to stand and strike from the outside. It's who's going to impose their own will. Douma now on top. He's in north-south.
We got about a minute left to go in round two.
Back up.
A couple of good jabs by Douma right there. But Marotte coming right back at him.
Marotte seems to be fresh each time that he comes up. If he can just keep it up, he's all set. Taken down again.
10 seconds to go. Again, another tough round.
I give that round to Douma. I think that's a clean round for Douma. He could be up 2-0. He could be up, it could be 1-1.
He definitely controlled it more this round, but Marotte was able to get up every time, get a couple of shots when they stood up. But I guess if you go with what they see, who controlled it more throughout the entire round, you're right. I think Douma takes that one. Still got three more rounds to go, and the way these two fight, it's still anybody's game. Someone could end it. You know, punch from Marotte, a submission by Douma. You never know.
And when I hurt, burden runs off my shoulders.
I don't know how much coaching you can give these two guys. They seem to be trying to do exactly what they're supposed to do.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty basic. We know what each guy wants to do. Brendon wants to keep it standing, and Douma wants to take it to the ground. Douma's got to stick to the plan that he's, you know, has worked thus far for him, and Brendon's got to be able to stuff these takedowns. Otherwise, he's going to find himself for a long night.
Absolutely. Here we go. Round three underway. Marotte goes up for a swing. Douma ducks right underneath and takes him down on the cage floor once again. We've seen this about 30 times already.
Keep your pressure. Keep his head flat. Set it up now. Nice.
Now Marotte's going to work an underhook, and he's going to try and sunrise out, stand back up again. You can see when he tries to do that, Duma's looking for a guillotine. Now inside control. He's going to hold here, catch a breather.
Smart way to do it.
Wait for Marotte to make a mistake. Marotte to his knees now, and now he's back up.
Exactly where it's gone every single time.
You can see that Douma's tired. It's a lot of work to hold Marotte down. Marotte, not so much work to get back up.
Right.
He seems to be the fresher of the two. If he can just stop these takedowns and impose his will standing, he can start winning rounds. Nice inside kick by Marotte.
Marotte's got the speed and the reach. He's just got to connect with a few more things. He's not doing enough damage.
Oh, big head kick misses.
Yeah, and he does stuff like that, and that's what gets him caught.
He's got the underhook back up again with Marotte. Douma's got an armbar. Marotte's pulling out.
Oh, he slides right out of it. Douma bleeding quite a bit out of his head right now.
Douma's desperately holding on to a leg of Marotte as Marotte spins.
And that's it's the exact case of what you said earlier. They're getting so slippery now, Douma can't hold on to anything.
Right. Douma's now moved to neon belly, inside his own corner. He's in great position.
30 seconds to go in round three.
Now move to mount. Looks like he's trying to set up an armbar. Marotte's trapped one leg.
Now here he goes. Up. Back up again. Less than 10. Marotte going for some furious punches in there. Doing some damage to the head of Douma. Douma bleeding in quite a few different spots right now. Three rounds. Look, I may have been wrong the first two, but I think Marotte's got that one.
I'll tell you. If you take a look at each one of them, you'd think Douma's losing this fight.
You would think so. But I definitely think Marotte took that one. He did more damage to Douma that round than any other round.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. It depends on what these judges are looking for. I mean, Douma had mount a couple times. You know, he had a couple of takedowns. Those four were really big. You've got to look at it as a judge that Brendon's hitting from the bottom. He's getting up, but you get points for getting up. I don't score points for the guy trying to get up because you were taken down. That's
true.
The whole point of it is he needs to get up. That's your
right.
Job. Your job's to take the guy down. That's a scoring point, but to get up is not. So, but he's still getting damaged here. So,
well, we'll see what happens. I'm sure we're going to see a lot of the same in this round.
We've got three really, really tight rounds. It could go either way with these guys. I can see it 2-1 for either guy.
All right, here we go. Round four of a 5-round fight.
Marotte looking to initiate a stand-up fight.
Let's see, every time he gets that miss, Douma goes in.
Yeah, big swing and a miss. He needs to land that jab. He needs to just pepper him with the jab, pepper him with the jab, throw low kicks. Nothing too high like he was earlier where he got the takedown.
Yep. Marotte staying center, though, controlling the cage right now. Douma trying to find an opening.
Right now, this is enough to win this round. Controlling the round, taking center of the cage, landing a few shots. If we ended the round right now, Marotte's winning the round, but he's got to be able to sustain that. And right now, Douma's unstoppable with his takedowns.
Yeah, once he gets a hold of you, you're going down whether you like it or not.
Nice right hand from Marotte. Douma's visibly tired.
Yeah, he's definitely lost a little pep in his step. I don't know how much he's going to be able to shoot in and take him down this time. Marotte's still bouncing around the ring like it's round one. But there he did it anyways, just to prove me wrong. Grabs a leg, takes him down.
Marotte's got a deep guillotine inside the opponent's corner, in Douma's corner. He's got a deep guillotine wrapped around the legs. Looks like Douma's on his way out. Yep, he pops his head out.
Wow. Nice work.
Marotte's up against the cage trying to wall walk to get out. Marotte's got one butterfly in. He's going to look to try and sweep with that butterfly. Send it back to the center of the cage. He's stuffing the head. He's almost out. Lots of blood from Douma.
Less than about 30 seconds to go in round four. Marotte trying to get up for his typical end of the round poundings. I don't think he's going to do it this time. Douma's got him laying flat right now. Not much movement going on.
There's a lot of work on the bottom from Brendon, and I'm going to score that for him this round. I think, you know, Douma's just, he's content with just holding onto the takedown, and it's more of a stalling technique than it is being active.
10 seconds to go. Almost caught in the chin. Wow. Douma's bleeding pretty good right now. There it is. Round four completed. Yeah, Douma's looking pretty bloody right now.
And he's tired. But I'm going to give that round to Brendon. The last round three was tough for me to call. I'm not sure.
So at this point, I mean, technically it is kind of close. It might be a little more Douma because he's controlled more of the fight. But what do these guys got to do to take this thing home?
Ladies and gentlemen,
very close. If Douma wants to win this round, he has to get a takedown. He's got to secure that takedown and keep it for almost the entirety of the round. If Marotte can do more of like he did in the last round, but this round not get taken down, he could steal it. He could keep his title. I think unfortunately, it's going to come down to this round for both guys.
Which is not bad as a spectator.
Your fifth and final
round about to get underway. Combat Zone 61. The amateur featherweight title on the line.
Your challenger,
John Douma, against Brendon Marotte, the champion. Here we go with the fifth and final round to find out who will be the champion.
Brendon Marotte is fresh as he was in the first round.
He really is. He's got a lot of energy.
Douma looks like he's caught a second win.
No time to hold back now. You have 3 minutes to make your mark. There he is. Douma shoots in, takes him down, takes Marotte down once again. And the cat and mouse game continues.
Now Marotte's working for a wrist. He may want to try to submit from the bottom. He brings a leg up. Yeah, he's looking for a triangle here. He may want to just try to stand up. It's worked well for him before. He doesn't want to waste too much time on the bottom.
Absolutely not. You need to dominate this round because in anyone's mind, it could be a close fight up until this point. And you've said it, this could be the deciding round, so you got to do something. Marotte trying to pound the side of the head of John Douma. Douma holding on tight, trying to get a move, trying to get something locked in, trying to end this fight and take home the title. Not sure it's going to happen, but who knows how the judges are going to call this thing. We got about a minute and a half to go.
Douma's now moved to side control. He's got knee on belly position.
Marotte throws him right off him.
Just smothering Marotte inside his own corner. Douma's just going to hold on for the win here.
1 minute to go. Marotte trying to stand up to get back in his happy place. He's standing up now, but Douma's holding onto a leg, trying to get him back down. There he goes. Back to the mat. We got about 45 seconds left to go in this match. Douma's held control quite a bit this round. As much as Marotte keeps trying to get up, but I'll tell you what, Douma's bleeding all over the place. Or should I say all over Marotte.
Marotte now finally standing with less than a minute left. Douma's just going to shoot in, try to get the takedown again.
Oh,
Marotte fires away.
Hard goes Marotte.
Ten seconds left.
Oh, with a couple of final shots to the head of Douma. What an amazing five-round match. Now,
that's the way to end the night. Right,
absolutely.
There.
And, you know, look, I certainly don't have the experience or background in MMA. And as far as control goes, you're right. I think Douma might have won that thing. But in my eyes, Marotte definitely had some moments where he could have taken this title. It's all going to be in the judge's hands. Who knows what's going to happen?
Yeah, it's definitely in the judges' hands. It all depends on how they want to, you know, what criteria they're going by. I mean, the takedowns could score a lot, and they generally do here locally. So I would expect the judges to give it to John Douma. But, you know, by the looks of the fight, the damage definitely goes to Marotte. But he clearly lost that last round. He was ridden for the whole round from his back, so...
But I'll tell you what, if Marotte loses his title tonight, this crowd is going to go mental.
Yeah. It's either going to be a really quiet night or it could be a really loud one. So.
Right.
Either way, it was a great effort by both guys, and it was definitely main event worthy.
Absolutely. Never was it too one-sided. Somebody came back, and here we go. I can see our ring announcer heading back to the ring with the final decision. This is going to be interesting. John Vina entering the cage right now. The fighters moving to the center of the ring for the decision.
Fight fans, let's hear it for these two warriors in the ring. Brendon the Kid Marotte and John Douma. After five exciting championship rounds, we have a unanimous decision. Wow. Judge Sean Cordero sees about 48-47, while judges Lars Borson and Sean Flanagan
get ready to run and wipe the blood off your stuff.
49-46 to your winner, and now your brand new Combat Zone Amateur Featherweight Champion,
John Douma takes the title away from Brendon Marotte, and look at. Here's what I'm going to say right now. Brendon Marotte smiling and congratulating John Douma like a true professional should.
Yeah, John Douma took that fight. He did all the right things that he had to do. You know, he knew he had it stacked up against him, against a nice striker.
We hope you enjoyed Combat Zone 61 Resurrection.
He did the right thing as the wrestler. He took him down. He controlled the fight.
Great fights tonight. On behalf
now a two-division
champion.
The
whole Combat Zone staff.
Combat Zone. And
Calvin Cater,
Jameson
Cater.
145 pounds here in New England. You're looking at the top 145 pounder in New England.
Absolutely unbelievable and an amazing night of fights all around here at Combat Zone 61 Resurrection. We look forward to coming back here on June 30th. Stay tuned. Follow us on Facebook. Check out our website. I'm Mike Katrobas. This is Dan Bonnell. Thanks for joining us tonight and watching these amazing battles. We'll see you real soon.
Returns right here. Thank you, and we'll see you in the summer.